Hi everyone, welcome back. In this tutorial on how to implement virtual scroll in the Syncfusion Blazor Scheduler component. Virtual scroll refers to a technique where only a subset of events or appointments are loaded and rendered in the visible portion of the scheduler. As the user scrolls through the scheduler, the component dynamically loads and renders additional events or appointments, even when working with large datasets. Now, let's dive into implementing virtual scroll in the Blazor scheduler. First, I will open the existing Blazor WebAssembly app, where I already have the Syncfusion Blazor schedule component added and bound to a tValue property to event data class. I have bound those events to the datasource property of the appointment data. Then, I have set the schedule view to timeline, which display the schedule view in a timeline format for a month. If you want to know how to get started with Blazor Scheduler, you can refer to the video provided in the YouTube card. You can also find this example by following the link in the provided description below. Here, I've also defined the resources for the scheduler appointments and grouped them. If you want to additional information on resource binding and how to group them within the scheduler component, kindly refer to the video links provided in the description below. Look now, as you can see, the scheduler component renders with 10 resources and 120 events. However, I need to expand its capacity to display 300 resources and over 3,000 events within the scheduler component. When you render large number of resources and events in the scheduler, it may result in low performance, causing delays in rendering. To overcome this issue, I can implement virtual scrolling in the Blazor scheduler component. First, I make some changes in the code. I increase the resources count from 10 to 300 to accommodate the rendering of 300 resources. Then I also update the events count from 10 to 300. By doing this, I configured the scheduler to render a total of 3,600 events. To enable virtual scrolling, I simply set the allow virtual scrolling property to true inside the scheduler view tag. Note that, by default, virtual scrolling displays only 30 resources based on the height of the scheduler. However, you have the flexibility to adjust the number of resources shown by utilizing the virtual resource count property. This allows you to increase or decrease the number of resources as per your requirement. Let's run this example application. Look now. As I scroll vertically, you will notice that new resources and events are loaded instantly, improving the performance of the scheduler component. Next, I will demonstrate how to implement virtual scrolling with templates. To get started, I'll make some changes to the code. Initially, in the resource data model class, I will introduce a public string property named designation. This property will store the job designation of each individual resource. To assign a job designation to each resource, I will initialize an array named designation and stores 5 different job designations like developer, lead, product manager, QA, and newbie. Additionally, I define a designation index and initialize it with the length of the designation array. Subsequently, I enhance the resource data list by appending the designation property to each resource and setting it to the designation corresponding to the current index. Now I have the necessary data. I can create the header layout for each resource in the schedule. This will be done by adding a resource header template to the schedule templates section. The template itself will leverage an HTML element containing 2 nested divs, effectively showcasing both the name and designation of each resource. In the final step of implementation, I will add a template tag within the schedule event settings tag. This element will allow us to precisely define the data to be presented for each individual event. Then make sure to enable allow virtual scroll property, which will optimize the virtual scrolling performance. Look now, you can notice that when I scroll vertically, the new resources and events with templates are loaded instantly. Now let me summarize the key takeaways from this video. I covered virtual scrolling and virtual scrolling with templates. For more information on the scheduler's features, be sure to check out the documentation link provided in the video description. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.